Embattled social media giant Facebook pushes through with its rebrand. Speaking at Facebook's annual developer conference, CEO Mark Zuckerberg announced the company is changing its name to Meta. He says the new name reflects its focus on building the metaverse, a term that refers broadly to the idea of a shared virtual environment which can be accessed by people using different devices.
From now on, we're going to be metaverse first, not Facebook first. That means that over time, you won't need to use Facebook to use our other services. And as our new brand starts showing up in our products, I hope that people come to know the Meta brand and the future that we stand for.
The rebranding comes as the company battles criticisms from lawmakers and regulators over its market power, algorithmic decisions, and policing of abuses of its platforms. The company intends to start trading under the new stock ticker MVRS on December 1st. As lockdowns ease across Asia, fashion brands and airlines are also performing well in terms of earnings. More in this report.
Fashion brands and airlines are creeping back into investors' good graces in Asia as lockdowns ease, boosting travel and leisure activities. While pandemic stalwarts such as supermarkets and gadget makers are taking a back seat. People are spending less time watching TV and shopping online for groceries, and once more dining out and planning vacations, earnings report cards show. Luxury purchases from China's big spenders, still unable to travel abroad, are also rebounding. Asia Pacific Airlines are offering more flights as some countries resume domestic travel, while Australia's planned opening of state and international borders has led to a surge in bookings. Airline stocks in the Asia Pacific region climbed nearly 5% over the last 3 months, even while global airlines slipped 6% due to a lower than expected return of corporate travel. The broader MSCI All Country Asia Pacific Price Index rose roughly 2% in the same period. That said, a recovery in tourism in Asia is months away, and China's huge domestic travel market remains in flux. And businesses including McDonald's are still struggling with frequent and temporary curbs imposed by some countries. European fashion houses like LVMH and Kering have signalled ongoing strong demand in China as appetite for luxury items remains largely undimmed, despite power shortages and a property crisis hurting the economy. L'Oréal CEO Nicolas Hieronimus said last week China's population and middle classes are growing, with an unabated appetite for beauty. He expected a Chinese government aim to narrow the gap between rich and poor will boost the middle class, a sentiment echoed by LVMH.
The COP26 summit, or COP26 summit, is just a few days away. Here's a guide on what to keep in mind ahead of the UN climate conference.
The clock is ticking.
Representatives from nearly 200 countries will meet in Glasgow, Scotland from October 31st to November 12th to flesh out the rules of a new global climate pact. Decades of these discussions have spawned a host of acronyms and jargon. Here is a guide. COP26 is the 26th annual meeting of the Conference of the Parties, or COP, which is the supreme body of the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. It's made up of representatives from each country that signed the Paris Agreement and meets every year. The Paris Agreement was successor to the Kyoto Protocol, the international climate treaty that expired in 2020. The 2015 agreement aims to limit the rise in the average global surface temperature. Countries that signed the accord set national pledges to reduce greenhouse gas emissions that are meant to become more ambitious over time. The Paris Accord legally bound its signatories collectively to limit greenhouse gas emissions to keep the temperature rise well below 2 degrees Celsius, around 3.6 degrees Fahrenheit, this century. But the countries also promised to pursue efforts to keep the rise below 1.5 degrees Celsius, which scientists say would help to avert some of the most catastrophic effects. Soberingly, the world has already heated up by just over 1 degree Celsius since the start of the Industrial Revolution. NDCs are the pledges that each country makes to reduce its emissions and to adapt to climate change from 2020 onward. Countries must update and expand their NDCs every 5 years. All signatories have submitted new pledges for Glasgow. The principle of common but differentiated responsibilities was enshrined in the Kyoto Accord and means developed countries, which produce more emissions in the past as they build their economies, should take the lead in fighting climate change. The issue is one of the thorniest in climate talks. The Paris Agreement sought to bind major rapidly developing economies such as China and Brazil into the global effort to cut emissions, adding the words, quote, in light of different national circumstances. It does not, however, require them to make any immediate pledges to cut emissions. Richer countries agreed in 2009 to contribute $100 billion together each year by 2020 to help poorer countries adapt their economies and lessen the impact of climate-driven severe weather events. In 2015, they agreed to extend this goal through to 2025, but the target has yet to be met. For perspective, a U.S. Energy Department official estimated that the U.S. alone needs to invest $1 trillion a year to meet its new climate targets.